Hello and a very warm welcome to Pune. We're at the Shiv Chhatrapati Sports Complex and it's Philippines versus Indonesia. Both these sides' final match in Group B at the AFC Women's Asian Cup. And for the Philippines, pretty much a done deal in terms of qualifying for the next round. Almost certain to go through as one of the best third-place teams, or indeed as a second-place team. The other match in this group today is Australia versus Thailand. So we'll see exactly how that pans out, because goal difference could be a factor. Indonesia, of course, who were beaten 18-0 by the Aussies in their opening match, but recovered pretty well in their second game, just going down 4-0 to Thailand. Very warm, 22 degrees centigrade. That's in the mid-70s Fahrenheit. Just approaching 7 p.m. local time. Philippines actually have done very well to effectively assure qualification. Women's football, when you think about it, didn't even start officially in Philippines until the early 1980s. And there has been a progression. 4 years ago in Jordan, they got out the group for the first time in their history. Eventually finished in sixth place. They're hoping to go better here in India. It's Tanianis at the front, the Philippines captain. As far as Indonesia are concerned, it's only the fifth time they've made these finals. It is their first appearance since 1989, and you could see the gulf in class when they played against Australia, and to a lesser degree against the Thais. Neither of these nations have ever played at the Women's World Cup or indeed at the Olympic Games either. On the face of Olivia McDaniel, getting a rare outing in goal tonight for the Philippines. Here come the Indonesians. Garuda Pertiwi is the Indonesian women's team nickname. Basically means Eagle of the Motherland. See the eagle on the shirt there. Sign off with a respectable display. Indonesians, not so much about winning necessarily, but they want to be able to hold their heads up high. Meanwhile, stand by for the anthems.
Please stand up for the national anthem of the Philippines.
Anthem of Indonesia.
Well, let's give you news of the lineups. Four changes from the Philippine side that lost 4-0 to Australia. Olivia McDaniel wins only her third capping goal. Harrison, Long and Castaneda all make way. So the teenager Malaya Cesar comes in at centre-half. And Tani Anis, the skipper, and fit again Katrina Giliu, they come into midfield. Remember, up to five substitutes can be used, and probably will be, by Alan Stajic, the Philippines-Australian coach. Referee today is Kim Yoo-jung from the Korea Republic. It is her first game of this tournament. Indonesia boss Rudy Eka Priambara only has one fit goalkeeper, so Rizky Aprila, who made her debut from the bench against Thailand, starts. Elsewhere, Remini Scherer comes in. Noviliani and Dwi are given a chance too in midfield, along with the highly rated Zara Mozdalifa, who will play up front. Anyone who picks up two yellows will be banned from the quarterfinal, but Indonesia, with no points and a goal difference of minus 22, not going to affect them. But they have certainly enjoyed the experience of being here. And they've learned from it, and it's basically what the coach has said. He said his players need to be more comfortable on the ball, and he's using quite a lot of the under-18s and the under-23s try and bring along the next generation of full internationals in Indonesian women's football. As for the Philippines, they had a huge win in their first game, with 1-0 victory over Thailand. Did lose 4-0 to Australia, but they were ranked 53 places below the Aussies, and it was 0-0 at half-time in that match. The boss, Alan Stajic, who was a former manager of the Australian women's team, said he couldn't have been prouder of his players. There's Eka Priambada. Just about set then, that's Zara Mozdalifa. Started playing the game when she was 7 years of age, very highly rated in Indonesia, their best player. It's already got more than a million followers on Instagram, apparently. For those of you who understand these things. Referee just waiting for the clock to tick round to kick off time. So where we go then in this Group B match, final match of Group B. They're playing the Australia-Thailand game simultaneously, as is the custom with the final group games, to make sure everything's in order. Straight away, Katrina Giliu on the charge for Philippines. She's shaken off an injury knock, Giliu. Made her international debut in this tournament. First free kick goes to Indonesia. Order, or at least had the ball in the net brilliantly in the first game, Giliu, only for it to be disallowed for offside. It was a wonderful volley. She liked to hit the bar in the same match. Didn't matter in the end because her team found a way to get a late goal courtesy of Chandler McDaniel. Would expect to see the Philippines have somewhere in the region of 70, maybe even more, in terms of percentage of possession. They were pretty stubborn, Indonesia, against Thailand. This is Tanianis, the captain. Just run out of play by Serena Bolden. Bolden's played a club football in Sweden and also in Chinese Taipei. She was actually once called up to the USA under-23 squad. Didn't play, so hence eligible to play for the Philippines. The vast majority of the Philippines team, players were born in the United States. Usually got one Filipino parent, which obviously allows them to represent Philippines at international level. And a lot of them are playing college football in the United States. They had a three-month training camp before they got here. It looks like it's paying off because they're on the precipice of qualifying for the knockout rounds. This is Matarang. Just couldn't quite bring Carly Filez into it. Alan Stajic, only appointed in late October, so he hasn't had a lot of time, but as I say, he had that three-month training camp. That match against Australia, where they were holding the Aussies 0-0 at half-time, we think that that Philippines team only contained three players that had more than 10 caps. It's a good effort. Matarang's throw. Came off Remini Chiret. Good play against Thailand. Brought into the side today. Asgrove Patua fullback. Matarang again with the throw. Just looking for that flick. I think it was met solidly by Teodati Septawati. Another chance. That is a slightly longer throw. Might have been a hand in there as Bolden went to try and control it. Fairly straightforward spot for the Korean official. Might have been a shove in the back actually as well. Either way, whistle had gone. I beg your pardon, it's given a penalty. Wow. I did not see that coming. Well, Serena Bolden with a chance here for the Philippines to give them a lead inside 5 minutes. Well, a slightly bizarre penalty award. We'll have to have another look at that incident. It's Ariska Apia standing between the Philippines and a one-goal lead. Bolden then. Oh, off the post. Not sure if the keeper got a glove to it. And then the rebound from Gilyu is very easy for the goalkeeper. Well, real drama here inside the first 5 minutes. Did the keeper get a glove on this? No, she did not. And the follow-up was very tame and it wasn't on target anyway. Hopefully they'll show that incident that led to the penalty again. Seems to be a misunderstanding. Meanwhile, here's a great chance for Philippines, and this time they are in front. Katrina Gilyu with a brilliant finish. So the penalty miss, now history. That was a fine, fine goal. No real reaction from Alan Stajic, but he'll be delighted his team are in front. Really well struck. Not the best defensive work you'll ever see. Come over the centre half's head. First touch was pretty good, the second was even better. So that Serena Bolden penalty miss. Doesn't matter. Let's kill you. After in less than 5 minutes, has given the Philippines the lead. little bit of naive defending, I think you'd have to say, from Indonesia. Ball went over the head of the centre-half and Gilyou was left with a clear run on goal, but she still had to finish. And she did that emphatically. Tani Ennis will take the free kick for Philippines. Should be the goalkeepers. Just about. Just for a moment, it looked like it might sneak through her legs. Well, here's a real test then for the Indonesians. If they can, having conceded so early, not capitulate, show a bit of resilience, and show a bit of fight and determination. It's out of play from Mustalifa. Tiodato just out of position there, the fullback, to get back quickly. So Madarang, whose long throw led to that penalty, this time goes a little shorter. Katrina Gilyou's first international goal. It's a big moment. It's only her fourth cap. Here's Bogai. Pulled by Niklat. That nearly worked from McDaniel. Almost reminiscent of that wonder goal that you might have seen Dennis Bergkamp score for Arsenal against Newcastle those years ago. It went viral. McDaniel. A bit optimistic from that range. So his team behind early. Another big test for them. Been in the job a year, Rudy Ekpe and Bader. Previously worked with both the under-19s and some of the junior players, even younger than that. So Tavorti will take the throw for the Indonesians. Couldn't control it, Carly Frilles. And plays club football in Carolina. Bump forward, set to Warty. No problems at all for Olivia McDaniel. It's just the third cap today, the goalkeeper. Confident enough to bring it well out of her area. Looking for a flick on from Bolden, who is pretty good in the air. Ennis again, made it hers. Strange that penalty decision. There's no reaction at all from any of the Indonesian players. There's no standard reaction that they were unhappy with the decision. They might be even more unhappy in a minute because Ennis is trying to give them a problem, and it will be the game's first corner kick. The thing with no ball boys or ball girls, you have to retrieve the football yourself. Plenty of blue shirts in the penalty area here for Miklat's delivery. The chance to deliver for Miklat. What a bad ball towards. And the defender just got a foot to it, and then a second effort from Randall. Come back to Miklat again. Made some space. Clever. A and the header wide from Bolden. Decent football though from Philippines. Just lost the bearing slightly, I think. To angle that towards the far post probably rather than the near. Another look at the excellence of the finish from Katrina Gilliu. Annis. Again, see virtually every white shirt back behind the ball. That is unfortunate. Well, that was a good idea to play that little reverse pass, because Gilliu would have been free if she'd come back a little quicker and been onside. That might have worked very well for Philippines. But at the moment, the Indonesians being seriously starved of possession. Miklat floated it onto the head of Cesar, but the flag's up. Plenty of time for Randall. Daniel, the goalkeeper, born in California. Same virtually the whole squad, maybe with two or three exceptions, born in the States. Bolden offside. Scored against Jordan famously, Serena Bolden, in the 2018 AFC Cup, 2018 edition of this event. Bolden will chase this. Oh, and she nearly made it too. Strong challenge, but a fair one from Chirat. Was Annis. It's asking an awful lot of Madarang on that far side. Madarang, a fullback that loves to get forward overlapping. You see a lot of that. And she's got that long throw as well in her armoury. Ravigliani. Solid header back from Randall. Bad ball, will she be able to get? Not quite. It's always just running away from Chandler McDaniel. Nice idea though. More dangerous place to lose it there, Septawarty. Indebted to her colleague, Shalika Aurelia, for winning it back. And now she's given it away. Miklat trying to force a way through. Cesar wanted to deliver that early. So just over a quarter of an hour gone, and Katrina Gilliu's fifth minute goal suffices the teams. back after Serena Bolden had missed a penalty literally 30 seconds earlier for Philippines. Annis. Space here for Miklat. That's a nice first time ball for Guillou and a very good. Well, no, referee said it was unfair. Yellow card. Let's see this again. The initial reaction I had was that was a decent challenge, but Shalika's in the book. Guillou's okay. She was injured for the previous game, had played a very small part in it, but certainly wasn't fully fit. Jessica Miklat to deliver this free kick, and four in the Indonesian wall. Sometimes see these curled towards the top corner, the far corner. Goalkeeper expecting a delivery for an onrushing player to head it. Here goes Miklat. But it was neither one thing nor the other, really. Straight into the grateful gloves of Rizka Afilia. The leafer trying to get Tavienti Dwi away on that far side. Good feature against Thailand midfielder. Here's Cesar quite managing to get Guillou down this left hand channel where she likes to operate. Hemmed in there, the Indonesians. Ball came off Guillou. These little short passes might get them into trouble, although they've worked their way out of that quite well. Set to Warty. Dwi. And Salsabila. The worst ball actually, nearly managed to pick out Amiatun, who was one of the Indonesian star performers against Thailand. She had a couple of really good purposeful runs from midfield. Got a lot of support. Annis. Holden. It's come off worse there. There's no foul given. Yeah, it's totally accidental coming together. That's no consolation for Vivi Octavia. So the long throw again from Madurak. Plenty of time here for Bogai. You can see the Indonesians retreating. Not really interested in attacking the ball until it gets into that final third. Bolden did well to get there before the defender. Chance to deliver as well. It's a little bit hit and hope. Cesar. Anis. Baldwin had actually turned her back on that, not that it would have reached her anyway. Ball by Randall. He had a good look at that, said no foul, but Randall was really being pressured there. The coach would love to have seen that from Teviente Dwi. And this is ball forward. Flag has stayed down, no it has not. Charles McDaniel just went a little too soon. Dicey game to play though. A couple of times now, Philippines players have been caught on the wrong side, but I don't think there's been much in it on either occasion. Just past the halfway mark in the first half. 1-0 it is. A goal scored by Katrina Gilliou 5 minutes in. That coming after Serena Bolton's penalty miss. Anis. Bogai. And this again. Trying to get Gilliou in and she's quick. But again, she's offside. Looks a very promising player though, considering she only made a debut in this tournament. A late starter, she's 28 now. Gilliou. Given away very cheaply again by Indonesia. This is Gilliou. No one had read that was the intention, try to play it for the fullback overlapping, but she hadn't made the run. Tavia. Just can't keep the ball. And here's a chance here for McDaniel. That's a very, very good tackle. Beautifully timed just when McDaniel was poised to pull the trigger. Great challenge by Shalika Aurelia. Especially because she's already been booked. She couldn't afford to get that wrong. Mr. Leifer on the charge. Pursued by Tanis. Good work by Aniatum. Really scrapping over there for no reward that time. But again, it'll be pleasing for the coach to see the effort and the fact that 25 minutes in, having conceded so early, they have not been breached again. Maybe we could do something with it. Not quite from Salsabila. Play either as a winger or a striker. Just actually lost the balance as she went to strike that. That's where she didn't get any power. Standing foot just rather went from underneath her. Cesar on the charge and she will reach this. What a kick. Rebounded back off. Let's have a look. And back off Cesar. He did. Good decision. Some of these decisions, I've got to say, I'm being a little baffled. It's a free kick to Philippines. Slightly better than a corner from where it is. going to be a battle here. See all clusters in that penalty area. And it's Jessica Miklat to take. Mother who's played club football all around the world. She played in Denmark for a season or so, Miklat. Towards the far post, that's a fabulous header. Serena Bold, I said she's a good header of the ball. That was excellent. Excellently, it really was. And the lead is doubled 27 minutes in. And now she'll feel a lot better after that penalty miss. Towering header. Neither of the Indonesians near had even jumped. Excellent delivery, top class header, 2-0 Philippines lead. We think almost certain now to finish second in this group. Amiatun, trying to run the fullback. Sevilla, rode the challenge well. Couldn't find Mr. Leifa. Miklat. Too heavy that. Chandler McDaniel had made the run, but he didn't look like finding it. Daniel actually made two assists on her debut in the qualifiers, one of the qualifying matches against Thailand. Once again, an Indonesian attack comes to nothing. Bolden. She might have tweaked something there as she went down. Solid enough challenge from Octavia. Matarang's throw into Bolden. He wants the throw, but it's gone the other way. Just about got a foot in with Randall. And a solid header out from Bogai. Miklat. Nice first time ball by Cesar. She is again. Now Gilyu. Decided to chip it in first time. Goalkeeper and defender just for a moment. It's a hint of miscommunication. McDaniel. There's the Leifa now for Indonesia. No support at all, at least not in front of her. Rafiliani. Daniel again. Tried to feed it out to Carney Friles. Philippines had a couple of narrow wins to reach these finals. They beat Nepal and Hong Kong. Both matches finished 2-1. And this had to go all the way back. Oh, Oh, good interception by Ami Atum. But again, just no one nearer, really, in a white shirt. The referee quite happy for Philippines to play on. Good first touch from Gilyu. Is going long this time, trying to get fullback in who'd come up, Cesar, and she's managed to get hold of it too and pulls it back and off the upright again from Bolden. Well, she's been permanently involved. Serena Bolden missed the penalty, great header, and now she's come close again. Just clicked the outside of the post. Some idea of the supremacy. 10 shots against one. Anis. Cesar. Oh, the nutmeg, that was nice. Yeah, that's going to be offside. Gilyu, again, I think just a little guilty of not looking across the line. Nice piece of skill from Malaya Cesar. Plays for Sunset High School in Oregon. Fortunately for her and her team, Gilyu was clearly in an offside position. And that's another giveaway. Frilles has the chance here of picking out a cross. She's got McDaniel in there, Gilyu in there. It's towards McDaniel, didn't reach her because of Cherere's challenge. Good jump by Anis. This is Gilyu. Cesar. Optimistic, but not a bad effort. Just for a moment. I think Aprilia might have been mildly concerned. In the end, no problem. Throw from Frilles. So just over 10 minutes to go until the break. 2-0 and very comfortable so far for the Philippines. Looking for McDaniel. Defender had to knock it out for the corner. Octavia, who's the covering defender there. So Miklat, whose free kick made the second goal, decides to go short with the corner this time. She's got it back and a chance to deliver from a slightly better angle. Way by Mustalifa, who came back to help. They actually had everyone back defending that corner, Indonesia. close call that. I suppose you'd have to say if they've caught them offside six times, the offside trap's working, but I'm not sure because on pretty much every occasion it has been marginal. Playing offside trap, you're not trying to catch a player a couple of feet offside, you're trying to catch them a couple of yards offside at least. Anyhow, 8 minutes to go in the first half, 2-0 Philippines, goals from Guillou and Baldwin. Forward by Jessica Nicklap, but too far forward. That's going to run harmlessly out. Actually, may not go. It'll have to be retrieved here by Aurelia. Ottavianti. Vigliani. Not sure the goalkeeper really wanted that. Guillou was almost in. This is Anis. Hit a hand, but referee ruled it accidental. Nicely done by Septuorti. Goalkeeper's come out and confidently cleared. Tavienti. Khalifa. Did brilliantly and then she ran into trouble but still managed to retrieve it again. Aurelia. Must be a free kick. Blake shoved by Guillou. Gave it the butter wouldn't melt look, but referee had a great view. Are in big trouble there and she got extremely lucky because Baldwin closing her down nearly embarrassed her. Clearance could have gone absolutely anywhere. It's going to be a foul on the far side, is it? Like it. Bogai turned 26 on Sunday. One of the older players, actually. They're a fairly young team, Philippines, with some exceptions, like the woman on the ball, the captain, Talianis, who's 32. Miklat. Was a bit short and it was easily read by Tavienti. Anis. Anis again. Indonesia qualified by beating Singapore 1-0 home and away in September. It's all part of a learning curve in qualifying the tournament proper. Try and get some friendlies arranged as well in the next few months. Been also difficult getting matches in the last year or so. The Atom has played it into trouble. Now Madarang, who loves to get forward down that side. Needs some help. She's given it straight to Muzdalifah. Now it's the Indonesian that needs support. She's got it from Amiatum. Still, I think she wanted to strike it, but just the control was lacking. See her frustration. Feels about right, if that is going to be the way of it at half-time. Philippines obviously have been dominant, possession chances. Indonesia, as they did against Thailand, have been dogged. Absolutely no faulting the commitment or the effort from the Indonesian players. Cesar's throw. Now Madurang. Got McDaniel waiting in the middle, but that's too close to the goalkeeper. Riska Aprilia. Klatz for Philippines. Now Giliu. Seems a long time ago since she scored the opening goal, Katrina Giliu, in the fifth minute. They just settled Philippines down. Always knew they'd be coming into this match as very heavy favourites. Lez, and away by Cesar. You can see the influence of Alan Stajic, the Philippines-Australian coach, in terms of their organisation. It's quite nice movement off the ball. They sometimes like to get the ball in early, first-time deliveries, and then can go long or short. That's a nice touch from Golden, she's offside. Again, that was mighty close. The slide rule in the pocket, the assistant on the far side. Anis. Niklatz. Past the challenge of Muzdalifah. Maybe they're happy enough to get to the break at 2-0, because we have now played the 45. Just a question of how much stoppage time to be added. Just a single minute. Good interception. Be a Philippines ball. I think he'll be reasonably satisfied with the Ekapriambada, certainly with the application, if not the scoreline. But Daniel trying to feed it through for Giliu, but again, just weren't on the same wavelength. It hasn't got out though. Nor is that. Giliu's cross might come from McDaniel. Challenge. We've played the minute. Will there be time to take this corner? Looks like there will. Jessica Miklat to take the corner then. And in fact, the referee allowed her to take it, but then immediately blew the whistle. So that is half time here. Serena Bolden getting the second of two Philippines goals in the first half. The first from Katrina Giliu after just 5 minutes. Baldwin having earlier missed the penalty. Somewhat bizarrely awarded. Half-time then, here in Pune. It's Philippines 2, Indonesia 0.
ステーションのラウンジで初めて会ったメダリー星人に、またでここまだ流行ってますかと。
What a warm welcome back to Pune for the second half of this Group B match. Philippines leading Indonesia by 2-0. Katrina Gilyu and Serena Bolden, the scorers. And it looks like we're going to have a double change for Indonesia. Marcela Juliana's coming on. It's Helsia Maisharor, who played from the start against Thailand. Marcela Juliana on as well. So just about set, and away we go for the second half. If you've just come in, Philippines in the dark strip, attacking the goal away to our right in the second half. And straight away, charging forward with Madurang. I just wonder whether Muzdalifa's picked up some kind of an injury. I wouldn't have thought she would be first on the list to be substituted. Meanwhile, Indonesia have a corner to defend. Keeper stays at home. It was Bolden again who got highest, but couldn't direct it on target that time. A jump. It was Chirar who was marking Bolden. It's out of play. Confirmation of those changes. Would imagine we'll see several from the Philippines, because I would think Aaron Stajic is on a rest some of his more important players, with the knockout rounds looming now for them. Given away again, they've done that on too many occasions. This is Thrillez, got an Indonesia player down. That's Dwi. Meanwhile, they're playing on, but there'll be a chance for Dwi to get some treatment. So if we can see how this, yeah. I think there was any intent there at all, but it looked painful. Magic spray, do the trick. Sal Sabilla, by the way, is the other player that was withdrawn. Tanik. Had it whipped off a foot there, Bolden, by Octavia. just seem to lose a little bit of their impetus in the latter stages of the first half, Philippines. They know they're going to go through as of right. Here's Bolden. Having a go from distance, but straight into the arms of Trillia, who's the only fit goalkeeper. She came on actually to make a debut as a substitute against Thailand. In a horrible moment, high cross. She tried to punch it away and only succeeded in diverting it to the net. She's looked pretty solid today so far. No chance with either of the goals. A free kick here for Philippines. Great deal with that, to be fair, Mashalor. She looked all right, actually, when she played against Thailand. A bit unfortunate that she wasn't selected from the start today. Exactly rushing to take this goal kick, Olivia McDaniel. A trip and a free kick. Liu upended. She's looked bright today. Should we kill you? Problem there, Jessica Miklat, but she recovered well enough. Well, that's a nice touch. Oh, unfortunate that Cesar couldn't keep it in. It was a lovely little first-time flick to the fullback. Ball for Frilles. Just played it behind Cesar. Made a bit of a present of it to the substitute, Juliana. Goalkeeper, just a doubt, was banking the ball would reach her. A little smile because it almost didn't. Would have been a bit embarrassing. No harm done in the end. To nowhere, it went straight to Miklat. She couldn't feed it through accurately enough for McDaniel. Miklat again. Cesar. Well, a little fortunate, I think, to get a free kick for that. Looked like she just slipped, but referee had a different view. Well, maybe there was a little hook of the leg at the end of it. Very crowded penalty area. Miklat to take. Oh, Cyprus at Aris Limassol, born in California. Delivery with that trusted right foot into a dangerous area too, and it might come for McDaniel. Goalkeeper in the right place. Not the most convincing defending you'll ever see, but they got away with it. Towering head of that from Anis. And again, she's very solid in the air. Philippines captain. Friles. Daniel jumping. Anywhere will do from Remini Shirah. Can Cesar reach this? She'll settle for the throw. Corner ball. Taken short and quickly. Niklas. Just tries to tease it in towards the near post. Not really properly away by Septuorti. Back it goes again. McDaniel blocked, and then Anis for the try. Good goal. That was well struck. And the captain gets on the score sheet, and it's 3-0 Philippines. It's her third international goal. She drilled this low and beyond the reach of Aprilia. It's a good hit. Keeper got there, really, kind of squirmed underneath her a little bit, but it was a decent enough contact. Yeah, just under her gloves, got a little piece of it. Oldest member of this squad, she's 32, Tali Ennis. Very bright woman, she's got a degree in business and also another one in sports management. She managed to keep that shot down pretty well and get sufficient power to beat Aprilia. Every time they get possession underneath, they just can't really create a chance worthy of the name. Struggling for numbers going forward. So flat out defensively. Put out of harm's way by Shalika Aurelia. Aurelia again. That's a nice piece of skill. Rode the challenge really well, did Dwee, but just not quick enough. Randall able to get back and dispossess it. Drilled for McDaniel. Oh, that might be a decent ball, just a bit too far. Pity. Not exactly where Serena Bolden was, but just gave it too much to do. Quick throw has rather caught Philippines, rather caught Indonesia out. But Daniel will settle for the corner. A little quiet period towards the end of the first half and the beginning of the second, Philippines, but they're back in the groove now as we approach the hour mark here in Pune. Six corners without reply. Three goals to the good. Mitchell again. Header was well grabbed. It was, for once it was Bogai rather than Bolden who got the header in. Polish team apparently called Bogai glue. Well, the coach came up with it. Do you reckon she holds the team together? Heard that one before. Jessica McClatt. See what Suzanne was trying to do, and she's got another chance here. All the time in the world for Mitchell. Sunday is going to be the big day going forward for Philippines. It'll be the quarter-final day. All four quarter-finals being played on Sunday. Up to Wati clears. Cesar. Well, hit first time. Not sure it needs to be hit first time, actually. It's Bolden trying to thrash it in from the edge of the box. Might have been under control that. Tell you what, that's a super ball. Madurak. Nice reverse pass as well. Gilyu's onside this time. Bolden, that must be offside. No, the flag has stayed down. I think she thought she was. The shot eventually is some way wide. Looks like there might be more changes coming. Octavianti Dwi being withdrawn. I think she's just seen a number. So Rani Mulyasari is on. Midfielder plays at the Persiba Balikpapan club. She's pretty experienced. She's 28 now. May as well give as many players a bit more experience when he has the chance. Rudia Capriabada. Meanwhile, they're pressing for a fourth here. Philippines just nicked out of harm's way and out for a throw. Piece of skill from McDaniel. Looks like Carla Bio has come on as well for the Indonesians. It's a striker. Do well to get any kind of service. Actually the captain who came off, Melina Novigliani. Now we've got a couple of substitutions for Philippines, as I thought there would be. Katrina Gilyu is coming off. This was her starring moment today. The opening goal, 5 minutes in. So Sandra Castaneda is coming on for her. There she is. She plays university football in the Philippines. Nika Castaneda is on as well. Baldwin is the other player who has been withdrawn. So clearly resting a couple of his big names. Stajic. Castaneda will chase this, but always second favourite to Ottavianti. Tournament point of view, I'd love to see them score a goal. Amieto on the charge again. Nothing doing though, she had absolutely no support. Haven't really seen the Philippines defence tested at all in the 65 minutes we've played this Group B match. Friles furthest forward there. Kept alive well by Bogai. Anis. It's a very good ball. It nearly picked out Anika Castaneda. Point. Should be the goalkeepers, not a problem. Bring massive amount of satisfaction to them if they could find a way to just score a goal in Indonesia. But you have to say, admire their fortitude, having lost the opening game as another offside decision. They lost the opening game 18-0 to the Australians. They went down 4-0 to a very well organised Thailand team. It wasn't a disgrace. It looks like being a similar kind of scoreline here today. Halfway mark of the second period, 3-0 is the Philippines' lead. Once again, the first of a loose ball. It's good pressure from Carly Friles. It's a good foot in though from Cesar. She's got it back. Well, this is nice football. Friles! Keeper couldn't hold it and got fortunate the rebound didn't fall to a blue shirt. Well, it's definitely a decent opportunity this. Nice ball in, clearly onside. Wasn't the easiest angle for Friles, to be fair. She had a defender bearing in on her. Goalkeeper a little fortunate. Rebound fell to one of her teammates. picked up by Miklat. The turn was Castaneda. Clearance that Chirard was looking for, but as well that ends well. By Yanis. A claim for player of the match, I reckon. Tana Yanis, not just the goal, but she's won everything in the year. She's really solid. She's a calming influence at the back for this Philippines team. Bio. Once again, possession, initially at least, was lost by Tunisia. Just don't give you any confidence that they're able to keep it. She's gone for the return, Madarang, and she's still got it. That was very persistent from her. That might be the best tactic. Trying to walk it out might give you a problem. An old-fashioned thump into touch. Madarang then. Again, just going to be looking to someone to flick it on unless she goes short. There was the attempted flick on. Really worked. Goalkeepers just about hung on. He actually had a wrong number put up on the board. Chandler McDaniel was the player that went off. See, the ball is still on there. Just a little wondering. Cesar. For Frunes to chase. Defender had to make the challenge. Vivi Octavia. Look at that little posse of players right on the penalty spot. Going to go in different directions when Miklat takes this corner. Bolden is one obvious target. Bogo also is good in the air. Signal for someone from Miklat. Referee, I think it's given another penalty here, has she? Let's see if we can spot exactly. Zooming, handball. She had a good view of it, the referee. So Miklat is now on penalty taking duties. Bolden having missed one. Miklat versus Aprilia. It is warm out there. Well, it might be warm, but that was very coolly done, wasn't it? 74 minutes gone. 4-0 it is in favour of Philippines, and an excellent penalty from Jessica Miklat. So now Philippines have matched Thailand's score against Indonesia. Goalkeeper started to go the other way, knew there was no point in doing much really apart from picking it out of the net. Oh! little bit of space here for the substitute, Maisha Raw. Rare touch for McDaniel. Ravel. Nice ball for Castaneda. That's too far ahead of Cesar. They still want to play their pass and move football. Got another change coming. It's Cam Rodriguez, midfielder, on in place of Madaren. Had to backtrack. Hammond off Juliana. By Septuati. Once again, Tanayanis sorting everything out defensively for the Philippines. He's a own oasis of calm, really. This was hit straight at Maisha Raw. That's the ball. Now they might be in business, or they should have been. So a bit of a loose pass, truth to tell, by Erika Castaneda. And it's again. First time that she's run into trouble all evening. Not that it stopped the flow of Philippines coming forward. Castaneda trying to get teammate involved. This is Morgan Brown coming on in place of Riley Bogai. Six-year-old defender, just her fifth cap. Looks like Aprilia has a problem here, and that's going to be a big issue if she can't continue, because I mentioned that both the other two goalkeepers have knocks. Not sure that's going to help. Very warm out there. As I said at the time, this was calm, cool and collected. There's a little bit of concern here over Rizka Aprilia. Well, she's up. Doesn't look overly concerned. The manager. Frilles. And this. Cesar on this near side. Seen her actually overlapping as often as Madurang, who's just been substituted on the other flank. Set to Wattie, it's given it away, but doesn't really look like Rachel Castaneda not on the same wavelength as a teammate. Flurry of substitutions. Isabella Flanagan came on for Philippines. And the player who plays in the States is essentially a fullback. Still one substitution in hand for Indonesia. Bolden has now been substituted. Gonna have another go. Maybe she is. Oh, yes. That's two now. Alice again. Oh, that was even better. Well, centre half, she's a goal scoring machine. That looked like it was going to trouble Aprilia from the moment it left her boot. One touch to control, and then one to fire in another really well-struck effort. It's too high for Aprilia to get to. So 5-0 it is. It's been a pretty comprehensive performance, this, from Philippines. I think Alan Stajic, the coach, will be absolutely delighted with it. He knows there are tougher tests ahead. Of course there are, but when you play against the team you're drawn with, and they've acquitted themselves well against Thailand, they've won 1-0. What a tall disgrace against Australia, losing 4-0, but they were 0-0 at half-time, and now here, 5-0 and counting. Frilles. Shot never would have had the venom to trouble the goalkeeper, even had it not been blocked. Well, for once, Anis was beaten. Alabio stops in the tracks, no foul. On by Frilles. Flanagan. Almost turned into an excellent cross. Might still stay in. It has stayed in. Castaneda. She assumed it was going out. She might have had an even better opportunity. She followed it straight away. There's a half chance for Bio. A rare sight of goal for Indonesia. Wouldn't have counted anyway. maybe just fractionally the wrong side, but close. Rodriguez. So Alan Stajic has got as many players involved as he could have done today, using all five substitutes. Castaneda trying to get Frilles away. And this is Flanagan, and Flanagan surely is going to make it six. It's gone wide. No foul, goal kick given. Looked like she was big odds on to score there. The substitute, Isabella Flanagan. Only a second cat. Would have been a big moment for her. Time to run well. Just a slightly heavy touch past the goalkeeper, and it allowed the challenge to come in. It was a fine tackle, actually, from Octavia. Just got something on the ball. Sectorati has lost it. Frilles. Neither one thing nor the other. Sure, I think she was trying the shot. Apologies for the issue. It is still 5-0 in Philippines' favour. We're into the last two or three minutes. And a final change for Indonesia is Vinny Sinfiris. Is Frilles, and straight into trouble. Goalkeeper wanted the defender to deal with it, and she truly did. This is Cesar. Top goal scorer list. Still Sam Kerr of Australia leads the way with six. Flanagan looked very bright since she came on. I think she knew there, did Castaneda, that she was in an offside position. It's been a very solid display this from Philippines, albeit against the highest ranked team in the competition. Finals looming on Sunday. Trying to play their way out from the back, and they've given them a problem, although Indonesia have hardly had what you'd call a shot in anger here. Oh, too far ahead of Phyllis, she won't get that. Oh, but it's been given away very cheaply again. Trying to ice the cake here with a sixth. It's a good little interception there by Amiatum. Otherwise they would have had a problem. Four additional minutes to be played and we're into those now. Castaneda. It's behind Frilles. I think it's the intended target. Here's Rodriguez. She felt the brunt of that, but it was a fair challenge. Surprised it's as low as 55, actually. The thing is, the Indonesians' possession, such as it's been, has not been threatening at all. Stretching to try and deny Karen Rodriguez. Still coming forward looking for a sixth. Cesar didn't quite latch onto it and knocked out of play almost gratefully in the end by Octavienti. Frilles, that's going to be over the top on a goal kick. So just to reiterate what this result means, Indonesia will be on the plane home at some stage. Philippines advancing to the quarterfinals, finishing second in Group B. Still trying to find that sixth goal. Anis. I mean, whoever they end up playing on Sunday, it's going to be a far different challenge to the one they've had to encounter this evening. They showed against Thailand that they're a pretty resilient bunch. A very together, happy bunch led by Anastasic. Cesar. Oh, the goalkeeper's missed it. It's going to be a tap in. Here it is. Well, it's a gift wrapped sixth with virtually the last kick of the game. Valea Cesar, the goal scorer, in the fourth minute of time added on. Could miss. Good work from Rodriguez in the build-up. It's her first ever international goal. Only her third cap. Lovely moment for the 18-year-old. There will barely be time for the restart. The referee's already had one quick glance at a watch. And that's all she needed. It is an emphatic victory for Philippines. scored early through Katrina Gilliu, that even after a penalty miss by Serena Bolden. Bolden made it 2-0 at the break. And then two great goals from Telianis, the skipper, in the second half. A Mick that penalty, and then right at the end, a Malaya Cesar tap-in. It means that Philippines will go through to the quarterfinals. Indonesia, their race is run. Philippines 6, Indonesia 0.